And that's how I invented cocaine.
Huh. Well, anyway, hey everybody. It is May 1st.
Happy May Day.
Happy May Day. We are here live for two songs that we are going to play about love. This month is all about love. So, Dale, what is love?
Does anybody love anybody anyway?
It's a great question, one posed by one of our great philosophers 3 years later in 1984, Howard Jones.
Howard Jones, yes.
But that's not what we're going to talk about right now. We are going to talk about love, and we are going to talk about temptation, specifically being tempted by love. Some of you may have been able to figure out that by the graphic.
Some of you little amateur sleuths out there.
That's right. That we are going to do. Our first song was released today, 40 years ago today. And it's off an album called East Side Story. Mm-hmm. And it's by a band called Squeeze. Now, Dale, this song is sung by who?
It's sung by Paul Carrick.
Right, right. This song is...
That you're going to give me a gotcha.
No.
Paul Carrick, yes.
So Paul Carrick is a fascinating guy. My father, who is not Paul Carrick.
Currently.
Although paperwork is being filed. Paul Carrick was only in Squeeze for one album.
Yep.
And he was only in the album for, I don't know, maybe a year, if that. And that's when they broke huge in the United States. So a lot of people who say they are Squeeze fans, they love this song that is sung by someone who was only in the band for a short period
of time. Just a little blip. Before joining Mike and the Mechanics.
Exactly.
He was one of the Mechanics.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You may also know him from singing, "How Long Has This Been Going On?" by Ace. Anyway, in honor of both that great album, the spirit of love, and everything else that involves May 1st, we are going to perform Is That Love by Squeeze.
Whoa, back up. Beep, beep, beep. I've been practicing Tempted for a month now, and you're telling me right when we're live on Facebook?
Yes.
Oh, well.
Yep. Dale, it starts in A minor.
Okay.
One, two, three, four.
that let the finger points now is that love the more you go down, the easy love is found. Now that is
Computer Liebe, Computer Love. Computer Liebe, Computer Love. Computer Liebe, Computer Love.
Thank you, Liebe. Everyone, that was Computer Love, also Computer Liebe, by Kraftwerk. Now, Kraftwerk are probably the most influential, next to the Beatles, band.
Whoa, that's a controversial take.
It is a controversial take, but it's also incredibly true. If you do any research, or actually, if you just read the show notes, after this, let's say I'm going to post them tomorrow, There's so much about Kraftwerk. They were responsible. If you like any kind of music from the 80s on,
you probably owe that to Kraftwerk.
True. Now, you may also notice, hey,
that little melody
sounds really familiar. And that's because, well,
just between you and me.
Yeah, Coldplay, they borrowed the main motif of the song for the song Talk, which they took to international superpower acclaim. And before I get all you guys flipping out in the comments, all you Coldplay fans.
Down, you cold diggers.
Cold diggers,
right?
Yes. I think they're called cold diggers. Hey, all you cold diggers, look, Chris Martin did actually ask permission of Kraftwerk. He, through the lawyers, asked if he could do that. About a month and a half later, he received an envelope with a piece of paper inside the envelope with one word.
A handwritten note, right?
Handwritten note. Yes.
The envelope.
That's it. That's Kraftwerk in a nutshell. Please, learn some more about them. Oh, also, quick bit of trivia. Computer Love, 1981. Amazing album.
Released when? May 8th?
May 8th, yes. Released May 8th.
Not and, 9.
Not 9.
But 8.
And it, fascinatingly, none of the members actually owned a computer. So, with that, a quick teaser about next month, which is going to be a slightly bit longer of a wait because June 12th is our next show. But June 12th, 1981... is
a treasure trove.
It is a treasure trove.
First-rate new wave pop.
First-rate new wave pop and some other incredible cultural happenings as well. Things that influenced pretty much everything. So, with that in mind, thank you so much for watching.
We leave you. And in case we haven't told you, we are the
Clydesdales. And we'll see you later. And now I don't know how to stop.
Yeah. They're getting a peek behind the shower curtain here.
Oh, no. No, really. How do I end it?